go to case study. This case study is based on budgetary control. Kavya, can you please read the case study again? No?
Yes, sir. Real Petroleum Corporation manufactures lubricant oils for motor vehicles, two-wheelers, four-wheelers and heavy vehicle. The company offers lubricant oil in various packages ranging from a 100 ml pouch to a 200 liters drum. About 70% of lubricant sales comprise are made in the form of 900 ml cans. The process of manufacturing and packaging lubricant oils are given below. Base oil is required grade are imported from Middle East. The base oil are blended with additives at the manufacturing plants at specified temperatures to produce lubricant oil. The plant has an automated boiling facility. The operator is required to present the quantity and number of cans to be filled in a computerized system. No manual intervention is required thereafter. The product is filled in cans at the first stage of packaging with 900 ml of product. Caps are fixed on the cans and sealed at the second stage of packaging. The product is weighed at the first stage of packaging. A conversion factor is used to cover volume into weight before the cans are packed into a carton. Any can having lesser quantity of oil is removed from the cans are packed into the carton. The cans which are short filled cannot be reused. Once the seal is broken, the can is of no use. There is no process by which the oil in short filled can could be refused. Hence, the product is wasted. The company is considering a proposal to add a component in its packaging unit to avoid losses arising out of quantity issues in packaging. The component will be installed after the first stage of packaging. The component will measure the volume of product and will forward the can for capping and sealing only if the quantity in cans is correct. In case the can does not have required volume of product, the can will be topped up with balanced product before the capping and sealing process. The company will be able to achieve 0% wastage due to short filling after implementation of new system. Required, using the context of control systems, identify and explain the type of control which is existing in the company and the type of control which is proposed.
Very good. Now, this question is based on budgetary control. In budgetary control, there are two types of controls are there. One is feedback control, another one is feed forward control. Whenever you are taking notes, case study number, you can put the sequence 1, 2, 3, 4 separately. Before you are going to start the answer in your notebook, this is the way you have to present the case studies. Put it in box so that case study is based on what, which caption or which topic, so that day before exam easy for you to refer that particular case study. So this question is based on budgetary control. In that budgetary control, feedback and feed forward control. What about the fact of the case? With respect to fact of the case, they are purchasing the raw material, oil. After that, they are doing manufacturing activity. Then, while completion of the finished product, before they are going to sell, they are checking the weight. Nothing but they are checking. You might have seen in the products and all, okay, or checked, some symbol will be there. So the product is everything proper. 1 liter can mean 1 liter, half liter mean half liter. Somebody has to check. So checking process they are doing. Weight checking they are doing. While doing the checking process, machine only going to do everything. Any one particular can or any can, short fill has happened. Filling is not happened fully. Some Suppose 1 liter can less than 1 liter is there, then it has been removed. Balance quantity only transferred for sales or distribution. So that is packed in the carton or box. They are put it in box and they are transferred for the purpose of selling and distribution activity. Here they are not doing refilling activity. Refilling process, refilling activity has been stopped by the organization. Why refilling has been stopped? Because they want to maintain the quality or customer satisfaction. In the sense of what? If they are going to do the refilling activity, you know, manufacturer's point of view is a correct only. Instead of 1 liter, some shortfall is there, few milligrams less. Then they can't afford to sell the product. Shortage is there, mean complaints will come. Suppose if I'm going to refill the sale because of the shortage, if I'm going to open and refill the sale, somebody going to the post, nowadays, you know, somebody use the camera, okay, refilling. Then they will suspect what purpose I am filling. Therefore, to maintain the quality, if it is not fully finished product, the weight is not, weight is fully correct means, if it is not correct means, they don't want to do the transferring activity. They don't want to sell the product to outsiders. This is what the process they are maintaining for the purpose of, they want to maintain the quality. Everything is proper, they want to maintain. But the intention is correct. If you go by way of this type of process, we can get the customer satisfaction. There is no doubt we'll get the customer satisfaction. But customer satisfaction alone is not important. On other hand, increasing wastage will happen. Am I right? Waste quantity may going to get increase. Because of that, company has to incur a loss. Therefore, they ask you to explain what are all the control mechanism we have to follow. What are all the control mechanism we have to adopt? That is what the issues in the question. Fact as well as issues in the question. Any doubt in this question? Shall I explain the issue or shall I proceed further?
Explain the issues.
Shall I explain one more time?
Yes, sir.
In that question, I'll repeat once again. Company is producing oil. Okay? Fully finished oil. For that raw material they are purchasing, they are importing the raw material. Okay, the oil they are importing. Raw oil they are importing. Whatever the name of the oil. Okay. Thereafter doing their further, they are doing some processing, manufacturing activity so that they can get what? Fully finished product. After the fully finished product, they are packing into can, like bottle or can, they want to sell the product. Like wholesale to retailer. Okay. After packing everything, bottles are available or cans are available. Before it's going to deliver, because they have to transfer the product for selling and distribution activity. Before they are going to transfer the product, they want to check, checking activity, checking the weight, whether 1 liter means 1 liter is there or not, depending upon the company's what, that particular cans, how much they measure, the measurement they want to check. If it is okay, mean they want to put some symbol, everything weighed properly, therefore we can sell the product. But you know, everything machine filled one, some shortfall is there. Then if it is not correct weight, then those cans alone, they want to remove from the process because they don't want to sell the product. And balance box, balance quantity, balance cans, they are put it in box for the purpose of transfer, selling and distribution purpose, they want to transfer those product, those box alone. Therefore, fully finished satisfactory products alone they are transferring, and remaining any shortfall is there, they are removed from the process itself. They are removed from the process, those can, they are not allowing it to refill. Refilling activity is not there. If the shortfall, if they want to refill me, that may be gain to the company, but at the same time, customer satisfaction may not be there. Therefore, they want to water. They don't want to refill the same. In that circumstance, one positive activity is to the company is customer satisfaction we can get. We are not refilling anything. So that you don't need to get any suspicious, they don't have any give or suspicious activity, nothing is there. You don't suspect our process. If it is not good, we are rejecting. But at the same time, negative to the company's point of view, everything I'm talking about company's point of view, wastage will increase. Whatever the out of 100 can, even one can or two cans, if the shortfall is there, mean loss to the company going to get increased. Therefore, how to minimize the loss, that is what the company's requirement. For that, we have to advise some control mechanism. So up to this stage, issues in the question only we have discussed. Now understood what is there in this question, Ganna?
Yes, sir.
Now.
Yes, sir.
How to draft the answer part. This also form part of answer part. First part, the first segment, we have explained the issue. This, because in final level, especially case studies and all, they're expecting the drafting skill only, not computational skill. So substantially, they're testing your drafting skill. So you should be strong in the theory part. With respect to control mechanism, what about the remedy or solution with respect to above issues? Control mechanism, to improve the business process. Business as well as business process. If you want, you can take the running notes also. After that also, I'll explain, nothing to worry. So what about the control mechanisms to improve the business process? That is what the requirement of the question. So first we have identified the issue with respect to control mechanism. That control broadly classified into two types. One is feedback control. Another one is feed forward control. There are two types of controls are there. Feedback control. Another one is feed forward control. Feedback, you know very well. But both the control must coexist in the same system. Both the controls are required for the company. Coexist with the same system. But then two designs functions in very different way. Both are going to be useful for the company in two different directions or two different ways. Both the control must coexist in the system, same system. So company has to adopt both the control, feedback as well as feed forward control. But the two design functions in the very different way. How it is going to help us? Two different manner it's going to help us. First, we are going to discuss about feedback control. With respect to feedback control, feedback represent reaction after an action. Reaction after an action is called feedback. Therefore, with respect to feedback, there has to be an error. First error supposed to happen. There has to be an error if you want to take corrective action. If you want to take corrective action, there should be an error. Error supposed to be there, then only action will come. That's why it's called reaction after an action. So with respect to feedback, budget should be there and actual should be there. We are comparing budget and actual, expectation and actual. That particular control is called feedback control. Comparing budget and actual is called feedback control. Therefore, it's a post-action control. It's a post-action control. It is for rectifying the problem. Problem rectification, we are going to use the feedback. Easy to implement feedback control system. It's easy to implement. Problem identification. It happened after occurrence. Identification of problem is possible after it occurs. After occurrence only, identification of problem is possible. Therefore, it's called corrective action. Therefore, it's called one corrective action. Types of feedback control. Feedback control can be broadly classified into four types. Four different types of feedback controls are there. One is primary feedback. Secondary feedback. Negative feedback. And positive feedback. Four different types of feedback controls are there. The next one is called feed forward control. With respect to feed forward control, it represents, it's a technique of measuring the error before it taken place. Before the error is going to happen, we are going to measure. It's a technique of measuring the error before it's taken place. That is called feed forward. That is, it helps to prevent the future problem. It helps to prevent the future problem. Feedback, you know, after happened, we are going to collect the data so that we can rectify the mistake is called feedback. Feed forward, best example, our own audit firm, chartered accountant firm. Suppose some clients is coming, they want to, MNC going to start the business or they want to establish their business in India. And we have to give the proposal or we have to give the advice, what are all the things they have to do? Whether TIN is required, TAN is required, what are all the registration required? Because today, if the moment they are going to start, there is no problem. After 1 year or 2 years, what are all the problems they may going to arise, they may going to face? That we have to foresee in future, now itself, so that we have to give the proper advice. These are all the mandatory. Otherwise, sooner or later, you have to face the consequence. Therefore, this type of controlling mechanism or advice is called feed forward control. So, with respect to feed forward control, object of the organization draft plan or budget. Draft plan or budget. This gap filling is called feed forward control. Feed forward control. The budget comparing with the actual, already we discussed, that is called feedback control. Now you have the better clarity. Budget to actual, if I'm going to compare and if I'm going to do the rectification, mean that is called feedback. Feedback will happen after what, completion of the work. Whereas feed forward, what is the object of the organization? What is the proposal or budget, the draft plan? So that connecting activity is called feed forward control. Therefore, feed forward control is a preventive measure and not corrective. And not corrective one. Next. Feed forward control, it needs extra expenses due to feed forward need extra expenses due to one is additional resources we need and additional investment we need. Whereas in feedback, we don't need much expenses. We don't need what? Much what expectation, expect expenses. But feed forward control, we need additional resources or additional what? Investment, both we need. So, control, if you are going to segregate feedback and feed forward. For easy reference, feedback represent corrective action or function. Here, preventive action or preventive function. Postmortem control, after occurrence only it happened. Here, foresee, it can foresee the potential problem, potential, even future problem. After completion, of all process, only feedback control is possible. Whereas before implementation of process itself, feed forward control is possible. Therefore, it's simple and easy to implement feedback, whereas costly to implement, you know, due to one is additional investment or resources we need, additional investment or expenses you have to incur. In feedback control, wastages are more. Wastage represent time wastage as well as resource wastage, whereas here less wastage will be there. Next. So note, check the savings check, the savings must be, what are the company name, Karna? Any company name is there?
Real Petrol Corporation Manufacturer.
Real Petroleum Corporation Manufacturer.
We have to insert the name also, okay? Or whether we can start with the company or Real Petrol, appa? Real?
Petroleum Corporation, sir.
Messrs.
Petroleum Corporation.
Petroleum Corporation, whatever the limited or whatever the company, has to check them. The savings must be compared with the cost required to modify in feed forward control. That is cost benefit analysis they have to do before implementation of feedback control. So statement of cost benefit analysis is the format with respect to cost benefit analysis, particulars amount in rupees, cost saving or benefits due to feed forward control less cost of additional investment or resources for or due to feed forward control. Balance is equal to net benefit. So the net benefit positive means we can proceed for feed forward control. Negative means they have to think whether we can implement or not. Whether they have to think, we can't reject immediately because depending upon the company, government regulation, other factors are there, mean they have to decide whether you have to proceed further or not. So stages involved in that Real Petroleum Corporation, that company, stage number one, buying oil, nothing but they are importing the oil. It's the first stage, buying the oil, nothing but here raw material, they are purchasing the raw material. Stage two, they are doing manufacturing of, I think, lubricant oil. They are doing processing. Then third stage, filling activity. Filling oils in cans. This is as per to finished goods and all, they are packing. Stage four, caps, nothing but seal. Caps are fixed, sealed in the can. They are fixing the cap seal, sealing process. Next stage, viewing the can, viewed the can. It's for checking process. stage 6. Lesser quantity cans. They are identifying lesser quantity cans. After identifying the same, that has been removed. They are not using it, they are removing. Lesser quantity can. That is what short filled scan. Okay, not refilled. They are not refilling, therefore that comes in the same stage only. Okay, they are removing from the process itself. Next stage. Other cans, fully finished cans. Packing and forwarding. This is for the purpose of sales. For the purpose of sale, they are distributing those cans. These are all the various stages the company is doing. Next. How to get 0% wastage. The company's object is what? They want to achieve 0% wastage. Such a simple one. By way of seeing the process itself, we can identify. The heading is stages involved. Okay. By way of seeing the process itself, stages or process itself, you can identify. Can anyone tell how to avoid the problem? How to minimize the wastage?
You have to wait before filling the cans. The machine should check before the cans are sealed. The weight should be checked.
That's all. So, such a common sense one. The two process or two stages, they have to interchange. Am I right? First, fourth stage, they are cap fixing. Okay, seal panirvam. After sealing only, it goes for water, weaving the can. But if I'm going to interchange, before I'm going to seal, if I'm going to weaving process over means, there is no need to break the seal for refilling the same. Therefore, we can avoid that particular problem. Therefore, change them. Stages in production process. That is stage 4 and 5 has to interchange. Am I right? First stage 5 has to come, thereafter stage 4. Before caps are fixed, or that is before sealing activity, we have to do weaving activity or checking activity. Should happen. Checking process should happen, or weight checking should happen before we are going to fix the cap. Therefore, or in this fashion, we can achieve 0% wastage. It leads to increase in saving for that particular company. So, what is the advice? Company should go for or follow. Which control we have to go? Here, which control is advisable?
Feed forward
control. So, we have to recommend the company to go for feed forward control. Can you take a note, Kanu? Kindly read. Next case study.
SW & Co. is a firm of chartered accountants having head office at Delhi and four branches in different parts of northern region. They are providing wide range of services to their esteemed clients. Their core services include taxation, corporate audits, bank audits, management audits, and project financing. The firm is preparing its budget for the financial year 2019-20. The senior partners of the firm have stated that they would like to pay off the firm's loan taken from a public sector bank 2 years back to the renovation of their office premises this year and to have a positive cash reserve of 2 lakhs by the end of the year. While comparing the actual cost with the budgeted data of last year, it was revealed that traveling costs were much higher than the budgeted cost. Fees receivable from some clients were so pending for more than 3 years, thus distorting the expectations of cash budget. Discuss the differences between feed-forward control and feedback control using the above information about the cash budget of SW & Co.
Very good. So again, the question is based on
feedback control and feed-forward control.
Feed-forward control. For your kind information, both the questions, issue was very clear, and especially this is a November exam question. November 19 exam question. Question 6B in the question paper. 10 mark question. But the question, they have mentioned very clearly feedback and feed forward. But upcoming examinations and all, they may not going to specify which technique you have to adopt. That also you have to identify. Okay? Because November 19 and all, beginning of the case study introduction period, that's the reason they specifically have given. Slowly, they will cut the issue. Just they'll give the questions, ends with the advice the company or what control mechanism they have to follow. Like that only they'll frame the question. Now, what about the issues in the question? It's a professional firm, CA firm. They are doing all professional work. They want to repay loan. Loan amount they want to repay. And also firm wants to maintain how much cash balance, Kana? They want to maintain
2 lakhs.
Okay. 2 lakh cash in hand or cash reserve for their running expenses. Next, they have observed traveling expenses keep on increasing. They are incurring more traveling expenses. Then it's a universal problem for all CA firm. Payment due from our client more than 3 years. Many clients are there. Due from the clients also very high. These are all the issues available in this question. For that remedy, control mechanism, you know, what are all the control mechanism? What and all?
Feedback control
and feed forward control. Feedback control, control C, control V from the previous question. Are you with me? All the points you have to write. Feed forward control, control C, control V from the previous question. Content remain the same. Thereafter, feedback versus feed forward control. Same points you have to repeat. Then cost benefit analysis, the statement also you have to write in the exam. How much the benefit and how much the cost, net benefit is there, mean they can proceed. Then here with respect to issues in the company. Remedy for the issue. Issues remedy. Feedback control and feed forward control. Both they have pretty much. Previous problem we have come across only feed forward control. Here both the control they want implemented. The first issue, repayment of loan. Can you please tell me, they want to repay the loan amount because they're having cash. Payment, repayment of loan will come under feedback control or feed forward control?
Feed forward.
Forward.
Feedback control.
Feedback.
Feedback.
Loan already taken. Cash available. After seeing the cash only, okay, excess cash is there. Loan is settled. Pannalam paapom. Therefore, repayment of loan will come under feedback control. Feedback or feed forward? No, better it comes under feed forward control. Clear? Repayment of loan. Feed forward. Why feed forward control? If I'm going to cash available, if I'm going to repay, what could be the consequence? You have to see. What is the consequence represent? What? Remaining running expenses possible or not? Whether repayment is worth it or not? So again, we have to do cost benefit analysis. What cost benefit analysis? Savings by way of interest. If I'm not going to pay, if I'm going to deposit elsewhere, how much the opportunity cost or running expenses, how much it's going to get affect, that cost benefit analysis company has to see. Therefore, repayment of loan will come under one. Feed forward. What are the second one? They want to maintain. It's based on what? The previous issue only. Maintain 2 lakhs rupees cash. Whether we can maintain, whether you have to deposit the 2 lakhs also, what will be the consequence? That will also come under the feed forward control. Traveling expenses more. Traveling expenses. How to control? That comes under the feed back control.
Then, client recording business.
From client, okay. Client bill amount due, that too will come under the
feedback.
Okay, kindly note it down, Kanna.
Hey sir, shall I read, sir?
Yes, kindly read the question, Kanna.
Fast Cook Limited is a pressure cooker manufacturing company doing business through wholesalers and retailers. The company is following activity-based costing system. Average cost per cooker is Rs. 600 and the listed price is Rs. 1000. But cookers are sold at a discount of 25% on listed price on orders for above 200 units and at a discount of 20% on orders for 200 units or less. The company wants to analyze the profitability of two of its wholesale customers, A and B, and two of its retail customers, X and Y, on the basis of the business with them during last year. This is to explore the opportunities to increase the profitability from the customers. The relevant data pertaining to the last year are given below. Customer A, B, X, Y, number of purchase orders 50, 65, 230, 270, number of cookers purchased per order 500, 300, 40, 30. Number of visits to customer place 10, 15, 25, 22. Number of ordinary deliveries 45, 50, 175, 200. Number of speed deliveries 5, 15, 50, 65. The activity, cost driver and the rate are as follows. Order processing. Number of purchase orders 1,300. Visiting customers. Number of customers visited 7,400. Ordinary delivery, number of ordinary deliveries 2000. Speed delivery, number of speed deliveries 6000. Required, evaluate the customer profitability by calculating the profit per cooker from each customer. Recommend steps to be taken to improve profitability from less profitable customers. List down the service organizations for which customer profitability analysis is useful. Explain the specific benefits of customer profitability analysis.
first exam question, which year kanna? November
2018.
2018, ma'am?
Yes, sir.
18 exam. Yes, sir. How many marks totally?
20 marks.
20 marks.
20 mark question. Okay. Whenever you come across case study, based on which case study, okay, which topic, kindly mark it. So this question is based on activity-based costing with CPA. CPA stands for Customer Profitability Analysis. CPA is nothing but advanced version of activity-based costing. Like standard costing, advanced level of standard costing we come across, right? So standard costing, all types of variants, advanced level of standard costing, reconciliation, marginal costing approach, absorption costing approach, market size variance, market share variance, planning variance, operational variance, whenever scarcity resource constraint is there, mean how to handle with the relevant costing, that and all called advanced level. Same manner, ABC, advanced level of ABC is called customer profitability analysis. Customer wise, you are going to prepare the profitability analysis. When compared to ABC, CPA is very easy. Customer profitability analysis comparatively easy only. Now, in this question, selling price of the product, cooker, 1000 rupees. Whereas cost of production, how much given in this question?
600.
600 is the cost of product. Discount policy, with respect to discount, two different types of discounts are there. 20% discount on purchase quantity or sales quantity is more than how many units?
200 units.
If the order 200 units or 200 cooker per order. If you are per order, if you are going to purchase more than 200 units, mean you are eligible to get 20% discount. 20% discount on others, purchase or sales quantity equal to or less than, am I right?
Yes, sir.
Equal to or less than 200 or less than 200 units per order. If you are going to place an order, then not here per unit, I am talking about per order, how many quantity, are with me or not? Therefore, here our customers, company's customers, wholesale agana, wholesale customer and
retail customer. Retail customer.
Two wholesale customers are there. Who are all them?
A, B.
A and the customer. A and the customer. B. Two retail customers are there.
XY.
Wholesale customers, number of cookers. Okay, second line item if you're going to see. Number of cooker purchased per order. Here 500, 300. Am I right? Whereas
40, 20, 30.
Therefore, wholesale customers eligible to get discount of
25%
discount on selling price. Retail customer eligible to get only
20%.
Now got the clarity, Ganna? All of you?
Yes, sir.
Now, statement of computation of customer CPA, customer profitability analysis. Customer wise profitability, that's why customer profitability analysis. Particulars, wholesale customer A, B, retail customer X, Y. You are only going to solve the problem. Therefore, kindly listen. First, shall we fill the first column? Similar basis computation. Can you please manage for the remaining three column multiplication, addition, and down?
Yes, sir.
Listen here, sir. Number of order given in this question. 50, 65, 230, and 270 is the number of order. In examination, they committed a mistake. 230, 270 based on that, they have given 20% for retailers. 50, 65, they are given 20%. Here, not based on order, how many units purchased per order, accordingly, discount is there. Second one, purchase quantity per order. For customer side purchase, forex sessions. How many quantity? 500.
500.
Per order, 500 units, 300 units here, 40 units.
40 and 30.
30.
Multiplication and all you can manage. Okay. Therefore, sales quantity. I will fill the first column alone.
25,000.
Similarly, you can fill the remaining. Or you want to solve now itself? And sell no. Okay. 65 into 300. You can fill. How much sales?
19,500.
19,500.
30 into 14. 9,200.
8,100.
Any one student can tell others. If they have mistake, you can others can write the voice. 270 into 30 is equal to how much?
8,000.
8,100. 8,100. Sales quantity. Gross sales revenue. MRP 1,000 rupees. Therefore, 25. How much zero?
2,50,00,000.
2,60,00,000,
sir.
Right,
right.
But how many crores is it?
2,50,00,000.
2,50,00,000. Second one.
1,95,00,000, sir.
You want to tell me number one?
1,95,00,000.
1,95,00,000. 92,00,000, sir.
Yes, sir.
82,00,000. 81,00,000. Less discount, karna. For discount, A and B 20% discount, X and Y 20% discount, that I have already have discussed. Am I right? So, 2,50,00,000 comes to all of them.
62,50,000.
1,95,00,000 into 20%.
48,75,000.
48,75,000. 20% on 92,00,000.
18,40,000.
16,20,000, sir.
16,20,000.
Balance equal to net sales revenue. 2,50,00,000 minus 16,50,000 comes total.
1,87,50,000.
87,50,000.
50,000.
Others also kindly check it up. 25,000.
73,60,000.
And last one.
64,80,000.
Revenue side over. Now I can go for cost side. Particulars. A, B, X, Y. For cost. Cost of production at the rate of 600. Liam?
Yes, sir.
Number of unit, sales quantity. 25,000 into 600, the respective quantity have to multiply with the 600.
1,50,00,000, sir.
1,50,00,000. Or B?
1,17,00,000.
1,17,00,000, Agana?
Yes, sir.
Then 9,200 into 600.
55,20,000.
55 lakhs 20,000.
48 lakhs 60,000.
So cost of production. Then activity wise, you have to compute the remaining cost. Four activities are there: order processing cost, visiting customer cost, ordinary delivery, and speed delivery. Now, activity wise cost, order processing cost at the rate of how much per order? 1,300. Agana?
1,300
into number of order. Number of order, kindly check it up in the question. Number of purchase order 50, 65, 230 into 270. Kindly multiply. Agana? 1,300. You know the shortcut? 1,300 common factor into double time. You can press into 50 is equal to what?
65,000, sir.
Immediately. 65 is equal to what?
84,500.
Immediately. 230 is equal to what?
2,99,000.
3,51,000. 3,51,000. Okay. Posting also kindly check. What are the next one? Visiting customer visiting cost. Okay. Visiting customer cost 7,400.
400.
For customer visit. 7,400 into customer visit. 10, 15, 15, 23. Am I right?
1,11,000.
1,62,800. Next activity, ordinary delivery. Ordinary delivery cost
2,000
into number of ordinary delivery 45, 50, 175 into 200. So 2,000.
90,000.
Good. 1,00,000.
3,50,000. 4 lakhs. What are the next one?
That is 65,000 only.
Delivery.
Not 65 lakh.
Which one? First one, Appa?
Ah, yes, sir.
1,300 into order passing, number of order. 50, check. 65,000.
6,50,000.
Confirm. 1,300 into 650.
65,000.
65,000 only,
yes, sir.
Second one, right number, Appa?
84,500.
84,500. 84,500. This is 2,99,000. Right, Appa?
Yes, sir.
2,99,000. 3 lakh 51. Is it? Check it up.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Speed delivery cost. For delivery, how much? Others also kindly help.
6,000
into number of speed delivery 5, 15, 50 and 65.
30,000, sir. First one.
30,000.
90,000. 3 lakhs.
3 lakh.
Okay.
3,90,000.
3,90,000. All the cost over, I think. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Total cost all of them. Total cost. Suppla mat panagan. One student tell you one row up and quick up and for
a 1,50,178,000.
Little fast. Four students going to participate one column in, you can finish easily. Another four students can verify the column also. Little fast.
1,52,59,000.
59,000. Check it up, Kanna. Second one, Kanna. Last
one. The last one.
61,63,800. Sir, column X, 66,54,000. B is 1 crore 20 lakh 85,500. What 1,87,50,000 minus the cost. Total profit.
34,91,000.
So column X 7,06,000.
7,06,000.
Sir, B is 25 lakh. B 25,39,500.
Y is
3,16,200. 200. 3,16,200. 200. 200. Okay. They ask total profit or profit per unit? Evaluate
per unit.
Calculate per cooker. Liam. Yeah.
So profit cooker.
Of the product. Total profit divided by sales quantity is equal to profit per unit. Sales quantity 25,000.
139.64
is a profit per unit. Similarly.
130.23.
Sir, next one 76.74, sir.
74. Check panikalarum.
Y is 39.03.
Okay, so up to this stage, any doubt, Kanna?
No, sir.
Easier ka? So, based on profitability statement, here we are having wholesale customer and a retail customer. From where we are getting more profits based on the profitability statement?
Wholesale
customers.
Company is getting more profit from wholesale customer and comparatively less profit from retail customer. Wholesale customer what about the sales quantity on wholesale customer sales quantity if you are going to see
25,000
total sales quantity
44,500.
Whereas retailer kanna
92 plus 8 17,300.
Total sales quantity
61,800.
Therefore, from wholesale customer, how much a percentage of sales quantity? 44,500 divided by
72%
into 100 is equal to from wholesale customers sales quantity. How much percentage?
72%
sales happen from what whom? Wholesale customer only. Therefore, company name Nedico. Company has to give more focus to increase the profit on which sales?
Wholesale.
Company has to improve. Which one you have to improve? Wholesale.
Retailing.
Retail.
Because profit is less. Now, what are the first requirement of the question? Explain customer or the okay. First requirement. What? Second one, what? Recommend the steps to be taken to improve the profitability. Okay. So recommendation also over. What are the next one?
Discount the service organization.
Before that. So other recommendation also you have to give. So we have identified wholesale customer, we are getting more profits. Okay. In what way we have to improve? How to improve? We identify the issue.
Increase the discount rate.
How to improve? There are four different types of activities are there. What are all the four different types of activities in this question?
Order processing, visiting customers.
Speed delivery.
Agana, speed delivery. These are all the four different activities are there. Okay. Now one by one you have to analyze. First, order processing activity. With respect to order processing activity, total number of orders, kindly add all the columns order. Total number of order. Total number of orders.
615
purchase orders. The 615 purchase order from wholesale customer A and B, how much the total number of order?
115.
Customer X and Y. Okay. Wholesale customer, how much?
115.
115. Whereas here retail.
500.
Therefore, percentage wise out of total purchase order, how much the percentage wise? 115 divided by 615 into 100 is equal to how much percentage?
18.7.
18.6. 18.7. So, like,
converted
19%. Uh-huh.
Okay.
Whereas here?
81.
Remaining 81%. So, for 19% order, number of orders, clear? Purchase order, they got 72% sales quantity, like A category item. Am I right? Whereas, 81% number of order, we have achieved only how much sales in remaining? 100 minus 72 is equal to? 28%. This is with respect to wholesale account.
First is wholesale, here is retail.
Wholesale customer and retail customer. Therefore, what is the duty? 81% purchase order, but very less sales quantity only. More purchase order, but less sales
quantity.
Therefore, remedy or what control they supposed to give? Company should fix minimum purchase quantity per
purchase order.
Per order. So that company can minimize number of orders. If it is minimize the number of order means cost also will reduce. Am I right? Cost reduce means profit will get increased. Sure. Are you able to follow, Kanna?
Yes, sir.
In this question, we are giving explanation. That's all. No? Case to part will be easy only. What are the second activity, Kanna? Second activity.
Visiting customers.
Customer visit cost or activity. Total number of.
Can everyone else mute the mic?
No, please. total number of visits? How much is the total number of visits?
72.
72 is the total number of visits. Again, same fashion, we are converting into wholesale and retail customer. So, out of total number of visits, number of visits for wholesale comes to how much?
25
visits. Okay. Number of retail?
47.
Percentage of visit comes to how much?
34.72. 35 percentage.
Whereas here?
65.
Remaining 65%. So out of 35% of visits, sales achieved by the organization, 72%. Already we got 72%. Whereas here, out of 65% of visit, 47 visit per kum, but achieved only 28% of the sales quantity only. Therefore, the retail customer more visit but less sales happen. More visit but less sales. I'll make use of the previous slides. Okay. So more visit but less what sales. So what could be the remedy? Business process re-engineering has to be fixed or fined by the organization. So business process re-engineering. So process re-engineering you have to do. For the, what purpose? To give customer support with less visits. Less number of visits should be there. For that, we have to find tool. Without much visit, how to give the support. Without supporting the customer, we can't survive. So, visit we have to reduce, but we have to provide or maintain the same customer visit. So then, we can be in the position to improve operating cost of the company will come down. That leads to increase in profit. All are able to follow, Kannan?
Yes, sir.
What are the next activity, Kannan?
Ordinary delivery.
Next activity, ordinary delivery, Kannan. Now, third activity. It's not a third requirement, third activity. Ordinary delivery activity or ordinary delivery cost. Same fashion. Total number of ordinary delivery. How much can now?
470.
The conclusion was comparatively easy. Am I right? What is available data? We are cooking in the different fashion. 470. Again, we are classifying the same into wholesale and retailer. Now, number of ordinary delivery. Wholesaler, how much?
95.
Okay, A and B together. 95. And here?
375.
Percentage of ordinary delivery visit comes to, percentage of ordinary delivery comes to how much percentage?
20%.
Whereas here?
80%.
Many 80%. Again, same story. More delivery happened, but less sales only with respect to whom? Retail customer. Okay. So what could be the remedy, Ganna? Minimum quantity per order we have to fix. Minimum quantity per order or per delivery we have to find so that we can reduce the cost of ordinary delivery that leads to incremental profit of our company. Next. What are the next activity, last activity, fourth activity?
Speed delivery. Speed delivery.
Speed delivery. Dear student, the requirement 1, 2, 3 is there means you can put A, B, C, okay, sub-point and all. Suppose requirement A, B is there in this question means you have to write what 1, 2, 3. So that values also the confusion. Are you able to follow, Kanna? Nice.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
With respect to speed delivery.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Rush orders for immediate, okay. Whenever they need immediate consumption, immediate requirement, they are placing rush order. Speed delivery cost.
130.
Yeah. What are the ordinary delivery cost and the speed delivery cost? Which one is costly?
Speed delivery cost.
How many times is costly? Double time or triple time or four time or?
Triple time. Triple time.
Triple.
Triple Agana.
Yes, yes.
Triple time. Thrice the normal cost of, three times more than the ordinary delivery cost. Total number of speed delivery.
135.
Wholesaler.
20.
Customer and retail customer. Wholesaler, how much?
20, sir.
20 retailer.
115.
Okay. Number of speed delivery. Percentage by how much?
15%.
135 into 100 is equal to?
15.
15, 15 percentage and
85.
For retail customer, out of 85% speed delivery, we have achieved only 20% sales only. Therefore, what are the remedy or recommendation? Again, you have to fix minimum quantity per order will give the remedy so that we can reduce the overall cost or speed delivery cost. Okay, next. What are the next requirement of the question?
Specific benefits of CPA.
What now?
Explain specific benefits of customer profitability analysis.
Third requirement, am I right?
Fourth requirement, sir.
Fourth, sir. Last.
Third pending, sir. Organization
for which CPA is useful.
Sir, repeat, Saranya, Anuma.
List down the service organizations for which CPA is
used. List of service organization which is useful. CPA can be useful. Am I right? Where and
yes,
all
sir.
We can be in the position to use.
Yes, sir.
No. Where and all we can use. Financial. This is a question, not direct question. Okay. Financial institutions like a bank, insurance company, they can use CPA. Customer wise, they can prepare profitable customer or not profitable, unprofitable customer. Other we discuss one problem in ABC also. Premier bank account, three different customer A, B,
yes, sir, yes, sir.
Okay, cross subsidization and all we discuss. Am I right?
Yes, like, sir.
Hospitality service. Travel, tour operators, they can be the portion of customer profitability analysis. Third one, professional services, CA, law firm, any consultancy firm, they can adopt professional, they can adopt CPE. Healthcare centers, nursing home or hospitals, they can follow CPE. Next, logistic services. So these are all the service organization can adopt CPE. One more requirement is also there. What are the next requirement, Kanam?
Explain the specific benefits.
Benefits, okay. That's a fourth or fourth, right? Fourth requirement.
Yes, sir.
Fourth requirement, Roman letter, and the Roman letter, 1, 2, 3 means 1, 2, 3, or ABC means specify the same okay, number only, okay? Benefits of CPA. It helps to identify which customer contribute profit for the company and eroding profit. So we have to identify which customer is contributing the profit, which because of whom we are losing the profit, eroding the profit. Next, whether shutdown or continue for the decision making, shutdown or continue with respect to one segment, whether you have to continue the service to this particular customer or shut down that operation. For that purpose, CPE we can use. Outsourcing decision making, whether that particular customer or that particular segment, we no need to do, whether we can outsource or not. For that purpose also, we can make use of CPE. Any other requirement, Kanna?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Comfortable?